Hi, my name is Bintu and today I am going to teach you how to run your first PHP scripts. I assume that you have already installed WAMP server on your machine. WAMP server is a package, you can say, that installs three softwares on your machine. Apache server for checking if the PHP scripts are working perfectly correct or not. M is for MySQL server for storing the information of the customers' items. It is a database server. And P is for PHP interpreter to convert PHP code into HTML to send it back to the browser. If you haven't installed WAMP server on your machine, please do install it. And if you need any guidance in installing how WAMP is installed on your machine, you can watch my videos on YouTube. These are the links. One is the link for the tutorial in Hindi language, and another is in English language. But why PHP? PHP stands for Hypertext Preprocessor and is a very popular web development scripting language among the developers. Why? The first is that it supports almost all kinds of databases which are available today. It might be Oracle, it might be SQL Server, it can be whatever. It is compatible with almost all databases. It is open source. The whole community is working on its development. Every day you get new PHP classes added, PHP functions added. And if you find any problem, there is a huge support of it. You don't have to pay anything for it. It's free. It can be easily mixed with HTML tags. You can switch between the two anytime in the scripts. And PHP is available for almost all the popular platforms today. It is available for Linux, Unix, Macintosh, Windows. You might be thinking that when JavaScript is there, why go for PHP? The main difference between JavaScript and PHP is that JavaScript is client-based. That is, it executes on the client's browser. So it consumes the client's resources. Whereas PHP is a server-side scripting language, it runs on the server and only the HTML code is sent to the client's browser for display. So it is obviously very faster, it doesn't consume client's resources. While writing the PHP scripts, the question is that how the PHP interpreter on the server knows that this is HTML code and this is PHP code. How does it differentiate? The PHP code has to be enclosed between these two tags. This is the PHP start tag, this is PHP end tag. This less than sign, question mark and PHP designates that the following code is a PHP code and it has to be converted. And this question mark and greater than sign is the end PHP tag to tell the PHP interpreter that use please stop converting into HTML. The following code is the HTML code. Before I go for running my PHP scripts, you have to confirm that WAMP is running on your machine. This is your desktop. I am double clicking my WAMP server icon. You have to confirm that this is in green color. Green color means WAMP server is executing perfectly. It's all services are perfect. In red color means it is stopped. Orange color means some of the services are not working. So if it is in orange or red color, you have to open this shortcut menu and here either you have to click on start all services or you have to click on restart all services, whatsoever. It should convert from red to orange followed by green. If the color stops at orange color, that means some of the services of WAMP server are colliding with the ports, existing servers on your machine. It might be MySQL server which you might have installed earlier. It might be colliding with your WAMP server, or you must be having another server like IIS which is usually installed for running your .NET scripts. So you have to close those services before you restart this WAMP server. When it is in green color, that means WAMP is running successfully and you can verify it by opening your browser and writing http://localhost. Click on enter key. This output verifies that WAMP is successfully running. And now you can go ahead with the programming. I have written already certain programs for you in the WAMP server folder. Recall that for running your PHP scripts, they have to be loaded in your WAMP servers folder. In the WAMP servers folder, there is a subfolder www. You have to copy all your PHP scripts for execution into this www folder. This is my first PHP script. This is a simple HTML code. This is saying that please display the line welcome to PHP in heading 1 element. So on the next line, this is the PHP code. This indicates to the PHP interpreter on the server that following is the PHP code and please convert it into HTML. Every PHP statement has to be delimited by the semicolon. This line echo means display on the screen. What you want to display? Hello world. This text will be displayed on the screen in bold. This B is HTML tag. Slash B means bold is over now. This tag indicates that the PHP code is over. So what will happen when I run this script? it will display two lines, welcome to PHP, and on the following line it will display hello world in bold. Let's run it. See, welcome to PHP and hello world. So this script is working perfectly. Let's run another one, sample 2. This script explains how the variables are defined in PHP. This is defining one string variable. This hello world is assigned to a variable msg. Every variable has to be prefixed with dollar sign. Echo is for displaying on the screen. This is displaying the value of the variable msg. So on the screen you'll get hello world in normal letters. Let's see it. See hello world. Let's run your third script. See, the usage of this script is to explain you how strings are concatenated, are joined in PHP. I am defining two string variables. Bintu is assigned to the variable A. Harvani is assigned to variable B. You are displaying on the screen. The two strings are, by this period, by this dot, you are saying that following string has to be concatenated with this string. So on the same end, it will appear the two strings are and the value of the $A variable, that is Bintu. Again dot, that is concatenate the following strings. And there are spaces, there are white spaces after the character and the apostrophe. So there will be quite good spacing between the concatenated strings. It will display the two strings are Bintu and the value in the variable B, that is Harvani. Output will be the two strings are Bintu and Harvani. This is says that PHP code is over. Let's run this. The two strings are Bintu and Harvani. Let's run the fourth. This script is explaining how while loop is written in PHP. I'm defining a numerical variable I. I'm initializing it to 1. Whatsoever the variable is, whether it is string or numerical, dollar has to be prefixed to it. This is the while loop. The logical expression is that for the time the value of I variable is less than or equal to 5, run this code which is enclosed between the two braces. So because the value of I is less than 5, it will go here, it will display the value of I. On the same line, it is concatenating break. So after printing 1, the cursor, the control will come onto the next line. The value of variable I is incremented by 1. So it will become 2. Again, it will go here. It will check whether the current value of variable I is less than equal to or 5. Because 2 is less than equal to 5, it will display 2. Then the value of I will be incremented to 3. 3 is less than 5. 3, 4, 5. After displaying 5, the value of I will become 6. This logical expression becomes false because I is not less than equal to 5. So it will come out. So this script is supposed to display the sequence numbers from 1 to 5. Let's see it. See, 1 to 5. Let's run more. One more. This script is explaining how to use for loop in PHP. Those who have done any programming language before this, C, C++ or Java, they know how to use for loop. Here you are initializing the variable I to 1. And until unless this expression becomes false, this will execute the code between this opening and closing braces. So the value of I is 1. Because I is less than equal to 5, it will go inside the for loop. It will display the value of I, that is 1. The control will come to the next line. When this closing braces of for is reached, control will jump here and it will execute this line. So the value of I will be incremented to 2. It will again compare here. If the expression is true, it will go inside the for loop. Otherwise, it will jump outside the for loop. Because 2 is less than equal to 5, it will display 2. Then it will go to the next line. On reaching here, again it will go and execute this line. It will increment the value of I by 1. So it will become 3. Is 3 less than 5? Yes. 3, 4, 5. When the value of I will become 6, this expression is no more true. It will come out of the loop. So this is just explaining how to display the sequence numbers from 1 to 5 using for loop. See, let's run more script, sample 6. This script is explaining how arrays are used in PHP. I am defining an array P and defining 3 elements in that array. It consists of smartphone, laptop and camera. These are 3 elements in this array P. On the screen, one message will appear, data in array R, and the cursor will come go on to the next line. for each is a loop which accesses each element of array, and it will automatically execute until and unless all the elements of array are accessed. So it is saying that please access the array P and extract its element one at a time and assign it to $k. So the first element of array P will be accessed, that is smartphone, and will be assigned to K. It will go inside the loop, it will display the value of K, that is smartphone. Cursor will come on to the next line. On reaching this ending braces, it will go up and will assign the second element of array P to $k. What is the second element of array P? That is laptop. Laptop will be assigned to K. It will display the string laptop. Next line. Again, the third element, camera, will be assigned to K. Display camera on the next line. After that, the array is over, so for each loop will exit. So let's see it whether it's giving this output. See, all the three elements are displayed of the array. So this is a small lecture of mine just to explain to you how to run your PHP scripts. If you find any problem, just mail me at bmharwani@yahoo.com. Have a nice day. Thank you.